O Lord, your judgment is right. Treat your servant in accord with your merciful love. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
It is actually reported that there is sexual immorality among you, and of a kind that is not found even among pagans. For a man is living with his father's wife, and you are arrogant. Should you not rather have mourned, so that he who has done this would have been removed from among you? For though absent in body, I am present in spirit. And if present, I have already pronounced judgment in the name of the Lord Jesus on the man who has done such a thing. When you are assembled and my spirit is present with the power of our Lord Jesus, you are to hand this man over to Satan for the destruction of the flesh, so that his spirit may be saved in the day of the Lord. Your boasting is not a good thing. Do you not know that a little yeast leavens the whole batch of dough? Clean out the old yeast so that you may be a new batch, and you are really unleavened. For your Paschal Lamb Christ has been sacrificed. Therefore, let us celebrate the festival, not with the old yeast, but the yeast of malice and the yeast of malice and evil, but the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Our response is, lead me in your justice, Lord.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Give ear to my words, O Lord. Give heed to my sighing. For you are not a God who delights in the wickedness. Evil will not sojourn with you. Response.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
The boastful do not stand before your eyes. You hate all evildoers. You destroy those who speak lies. The Lord abhors the bloodthirsty and deceitful. Response.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
Let all who take refuge in you rejoice. Let them ever sing for joy. Spread your protection over them, so that those who love your name may exalt in you. Response.
Lead me in your justice, Lord.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory
Jesus entered the synagogue and taught, and there was a man there whose right hand was withered. The scribes and the Pharisees watched him to see whether he would cure on the Sabbath, so that they might find an accusation against him. Even though Jesus knew what they were thinking, he said to the man who had the withered hand, "Come and stand here." He got up and stood there. Then Jesus said to them, "I ask you, is it lawful to do good or to do harm on the Sabbath, to save life or to destroy it?" After looking around at all of them, Jesus said to him, "Stretch out your hand." He did so, and his hand was restored. And they were filled with fury and discussed with one another what they might do to Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If you're not aware of who this is my friend, Father Paul Sims. He's the pastor in Williams Lake. He's a lot younger than me, 10 years, so he'll probably live longer than I, so that's good. Today, when we look at the readings, we have this beautiful thread of intense love. In the first reading, we hear Paul telling the community, "You need to excommunicate this fellow." And we may think, like, well, that's pretty harsh and judgmental. But St. Paul actually is the one who truly loves this character. By cutting him off, it's not because Paul hates this guy. Paul loves this guy so much that he is willing to be separated, and I'm sure the way Paul loved was intense. He wasn't separating this from this person because of hatred, but for love of this man's soul. To say, look, we're not going to pretend that you are part of a heavenly community when you're not. You know, you need to reconcile yourself with God. And fascinating, in this, the first letter of Corinthians, Paul commands this, that they separate from this man. But interestingly, in the second letter of the Corinthians, Paul tells the community, this guy has repented. You need to take him back. So Paul's remedy was very powerful in the fact that the man was able to come back to God and have his soul saved. So when we really think of excommunication, of course we could do it in hatred, it's actually the ultimate sign of love to tell someone very simply, look, your soul is in grave jeopardy. You have been excommunicated. You've been put outside of the sacramental system of the church. You need to come back. You need to reconcile these aspects of your life. And I'm certain that Paul did it actually in love. And then in the gospel, we have another beautiful same story of love. You know, the Pharisees, the whole pharisaical movement, was to be separate, to separate from evil. And here we have Jesus. He knows that they hate him. He knows that they're looking for something to go against him. But in his love for this character that has the withered hand, he still reaches out and cures him. He acts in such intense love. You know, in the first reading, we have Paul acting in love, we have Jesus acting in radical love in the gospel here. And these holy words from the sacred scripture should give us this encouragement on how you and I are able to act with the grace of God. How God is going to infuse his love into our hearts today so that we can also act in this radical loving way where we care more about the soul of another person than what people think is a community against us, as Christ is able to show us. Love has the power to overcome and strengthen us in a way to act. So God is inviting us to act in that radical love today, in that love that comes right from the core of our being through the grace of God. It's here for us. It's here for us in the Eucharist. We experience that life-giving love, that sacrificial love, and we have that opportunity to participate. God is waiting for you and I to open our hearts to the grace of this love. Dear brothers and sisters, gathered as one to celebrate the good things we receive from our God, let us ask Him to prompt in us prayers that are worthy of His hearing. We pray for our Holy Father Francis, for Pope Emeritus Benedict, for our Bishop Joseph, for their health and gentleness and constant growth in faith, hope, and charity, and for the grace of heroic leadership during this time for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We pray that we can draw strength from the radical love that is being offered us in the Eucharist, the radical mercy, the radical grace, so that we too may imitate Christ today in our lives for this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for peace in the world, nations and people will reconcile, will learn that we have a common purpose and a goal to grow in holiness and to imitate Christ. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick and the dying, those who will die today, for God's merciful and loving hand to be upon them. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for us priests as we head on vacation, that we will truly glorify God with our lives and enjoy safety and good brotherhood. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In our moment of silence, we offer our own prayers and petitions. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the holy souls in purgatory, and we ask them to join us with the saints and angels in heaven, especially Saint Joseph, our Blessed Mother, Saint Regina, to pray for more vocations to the priesthood, to the consecrated life and the holy matrimony, to preserve all those in their vocations, and assist us in our universal call of holiness. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the petitions of your church be pleasing in your sight, O Lord, so that we may receive from your mercy what we cannot ask out of confidence in our own merit, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread of the offering, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of heaven.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and earth of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
grant that through this offering we may give fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mysteries we may be faithfully united in mind and heart. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty angel of love, for although you have known me of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift. Since our praise adds nothing to your greatness, the prophets is for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Think holy metaphor these gifts we pray, ascending down your spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one. Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Thank you. Like the deer that yearns for running streams, my soul is yearning for you, my God. My soul is thirsting for God, the living God. Let us pray.